Having escaped from Dr. Aiken's laboratory with the knowledge that a Professor Krebspawn might have the artifact.
Krebspawn had better have more answers than Aiken did. This is Kane.
Hi, it's Frost. I've got a little more information for you on Professor Krebspawn. He began working at the university about 15 years ago under the name of Thomas Ellard. Over the years, he made several significant archaeological finds that gave the university a lot of notoriety. Due to his success, he was later promoted to head of the archaeology department.
I'm happy for him. So is this his personal residence or his office?
Both. He received a grant from the government to further his research on ancient pagan civilizations, so the university is allowing him to live and work in the old dean's house.
Is he here alone?
I don't know. He probably has at least a few servants or assistants.
All right. I'm gonna go see what I can find.
Okay. I'm also picking up very large psionic readings from the building. It could be the artifact you're looking for, or some other psionic activity. Either way, be sure to watch your step.
Thanks for the tip.
Oh, and remember, they know him as Professor Ellard. They probably never heard of the name Krebspawn.
Got it.
Yes?
Hi, I'd like to speak to Professor Ellard. Is he in?
I'm sorry, sir, but the professor isn't seeing visitors at this hour. You'll have to come back tomorrow. Yes?
I'm sure Professor Eller will see me. It's extremely important.
As I stated earlier, the professor isn't seeing anyone tonight. I'm sorry, sir, but you'll have to come back tomorrow. What now?
Tell the professor that I'm here to talk about Elijah Krebspawn.
One moment, please. Please come in. Please wait here in the foyer, and the professor will be out shortly.
Thanks. Guy definitely has issues with organized religion. I sure hope this isn't one of Krebspawn's relatives.
Good evening. I am Professor Ellard, and you are?
Agent Kane with the Department of National Psionic Control.
And what brings you here tonight, Agent Kane?
I'm looking for something that I believe you might have.
All right, I have a few minutes. Let's take a walk, and you can tell me exactly what it is you're looking for.
Okay, lead the way.
So tell me, Agent, how did you come upon the name Krebspawn?
I paid a visit to Aiken Pharmaceuticals today and I learned a few things about you.
Interesting. tell me, when you were at Aiken Pharmaceuticals, did you speak with Dr. Aiken herself?
As a matter of fact, I did.
Very interesting indeed. So, did Dr. Aiken happen to mention anything to you about your childhood?
Look, Aiken already hit me with that nonsense. And you know what? I refuse to believe that Abel and I are nothing more than scientific creations born from her twisted mind. This is a sick game you two are playing, and I'm done with it.
Why, such hostility. I'm sure you'll be ready to accept the truth soon enough.
Alright, how about we spend less time talking about me and more time talking about you?
Of course. This way. As you may or may not know, Dr. Aiken and I go back about 30 years. I, like everyone else, admired her groundbreaking studies on the human brain and hope to someday be able to work with her in some capacity.
And that's when you discovered the artifact.
Ah, I see you've been doing your homework, Agent Kane. As you call it, was unearthed during an archaeological dig in the Middle East and was the single greatest find in the history of this world.
If this artifact is so great, then how come I've never heard of it?
Agent Kane, finds like this aren't exactly broadcast on the nightly news.
Okay, so what exactly is this artifact?
You wouldn't believe me if I told you. What I will tell you is that we were extremely perplexed by what we found on the dig, and we knew instantly that it was no ordinary find. In fact, the artifact was such an enigma to us that there was simply no way we could continue our research without assistance.
Who is we?
Myself and Professor Garland Troy. We attended university together and often collaborated on archaeological research. Professor Troy and I were the only two present when the artifact was found.
So where is Professor Troy now?
Unfortunately, he's gone.
So how does Dr. Aiken fit into all of this?
Well, when Professor Troy and I found the artifact, we unanimously concluded that there was only one person in the entire world who could help us with it, and that was Dr. Joan Aiken.
Wait a minute. Dr. Aiken is an expert on genetics in the human brain. How could she possibly help with an artifact that was unearthed in the middle of the desert?
Like I said before, this was no ordinary find.
Excuse me, I'm sorry to interrupt, Professor, but you have an important phone call in the study.
Just tell them I'll call them back later.
Sir, it's the Dean, and he said he needs to speak with you immediately.
Kane, I apologize, but I must take this call. If you don't mind waiting in here for a few minutes, I'll be back shortly.
Take your time.